Hello and welcome to Unit 7.2. In this unit, we want to import and prepare the crystallographic information of HCUST1 into Topos. Download the zip file that we provide as an additional material to this unit. Extract it to a location of your choice. In this case, I choose my desktop. Now I have another folder in which there is a ZIP file. Please keep the ZIP file inside this folder, because it is easier to work with Topos that way. Now open Topos. We will now import the ZIP file. Go to Database, click Import. Go to the location where you have placed the folder of HCUST1 and choose the ZIP file and open it. Topos will then ask you to create a Topos database file. You can just click OK. It asks you to confirm to create this database and you click Yes. Now you have to enter a user code, and I always enter 1 and hit OK. But you can enter any value except 0. We have converted one compound. Now HCUST1 shows up in your Topos database.
Before we can determine the underlying net of HCUST1, we must first create an adjacency matrix.
What is an adjacency matrix?
Computer programs like Topos use an adjacency matrix to keep tracks of all the connections between atoms.
Let me show you how this works in principle with this hypothetical 5-atomic molecule. A very simple adjacency matrix for this molecule looks like this. If any two atoms are connected, the corresponding cell of this entry has the value 1. If there is no connection, the value is 0. A simple adjacency matrix like this can easily be prepared by hand.
But in the case of our example HCUST1, we use an algorithm within Topos to build an adjacency matrix, which is then a little more complex than this one here. Because the adjacency matrix in Topos also documents the type of connection between atoms. For example, if two atoms are connected to each other via a covalent or a hydrogen bond.
Now, let's build the adjacency matrix in Topos. Select HCUST1 and then click on this button to run the auto CN routine. Another window opens. There are plenty of options available, but we can ignore all these because the default settings of Topos work just fine for us. So we just hit run. And this window produces a little text with details on the adjacency matrix. The adjacency matrix itself is stored within the Topos database of HCUST1. We can close this window. And usually a warning like this pops up. This is harmless. We can just click OK because all the information we need is stored inside the adjacency matrix. To view the adjacency matrix, right-click on the HCUST1 entry and click Edit. Now move to the adjacency matrix tab. There you see a list of all the atoms inside the crystal structure. You can unfold each entry to view the bonding partners of the respective atoms in the crystal structure. Topos also offers the possibility to display the imported crystal structure. Click on the pencil symbol and a new window opens. And if you click on this pencil again, a single unit cell is drawn. You can also rotate the structure by using the rotate tool. Of course, there are also different styles of representation available. Click Display, Model, and choose, for instance, the sphere and wire mode. What I like about this viewer in particular is the growth function. Simply click on this leaf and your structure will grow bond by bond. Give it a try.
If the extended network now exceeds your screen, hit space for an automatic fit to screen.
You can also change the color of the atoms by using the magic wand tool. Select the magic wand from the toolbar and then click on the respective element in the legend to change the color of this element. Okay, that's it for this unit. Now I suggest that you try out the viewer a little bit and get to know its functions.